Hello everyone, how are you guys doing? Hopefully you guys are having a wonderful day, and today we are here with episode number 77 of Free to Play 2 Max, a series where, at one point, long ago, I was free to play, and after many, many sweaty hours, here we are in, not a maxing form yet, but we're getting there. 60 total levels away from maxing, obviously 60 very long and tedious total levels, but that is where we are at. We are trying. The bank is at 800 mil. I will still be working on this a decent bit. It won't be the focus. Mostly I'll be focusing on skills, but I'll be doing a little bit in regard to the bank. Since last episode, I probably did like 150k mining, 150k runecrafting. I'll work on both those levels, but it's hard as hell. Been doing a little bit of smithing too. Gonna work in some faster skills with the slower skills, you know, try to make it doable. But yeah, with all that said, all the skilling talk, I think I'm actually gonna go out in the wilderness and use the wilderness slayer. Last video we basically had no slayer, and that was the first video in a long time with no slayer, so you know what, we've worked hard, we deserve this, we can treat ourselves now. I really just want to do bossing to get my bank up in general, and I don't want to camp one boss that I've already done. Eventually, maybe I'll camp bosses weekly. I've done that before in the past, and I could definitely see myself doing that again. But while I'm doing these long, tedious grinds and skills, I also don't want to do a weekly, or I guess a week, every week and a half, grind a boss with those as well, because then it just kind of burns me from both aspects of the game. So we'll definitely look to do some bosses and whatnot. And honestly, I'll even be focusing on wilderness bosses, because there are a lot of pets and a lot of money that I can get out there. So let's go. I'm gonna buy Vigorous Chainmace, a crossbow, just some cheap chargeables. Yeah, I guess I'll do Wilderness Slayer until I can no longer justify. I need to get my defense up as well, which is why I'm kind of working on it. Vigorous Chainmace would be good for that, and yeah, that's the plan. So if I end up dying a ton, I'm just gonna say screw it and use the rest of my slayer points, but hopefully I don't die a lot. Well, I was doing something on another account, so I just kind of had to come back a second later, but we did get a Trident in the Sea, so nice little 1 mil going on into the bank there, and I'm finishing off this Kraken task so that I can go back to the Wildy, and we'll see how that adventure goes. I'm not too optimistic, but, you know, we'll give it a go and take our beating, I guess. So now, we can go ahead and just get ourselves a drop after a scuff raid, you know? A little 59 KC, a bunch of nothing, oh boy. A little white chest action. Love to see another completed raid, though. Not a white chest, I guess, but it's good stuff, up to 59 KC overall. Been doing a decent bit lately, probably like 13, 14 KC this episode. Bunch of nothing, that's why Chambers is tough, because, I mean, it's not like, I don't know. Not like I really should be seeing a ton, but I don't even know if I've seen anything this far. It'd be hard pressed to think I even got something, maybe an arcane, but nothing memorable, nothing that I even think is noteworthy. First wilderness task of the video done, and yeah, revenants were pretty tough. I did get away once through the agility shortcut and actually saved my life, so spared me probably like 800k, so nice to be able to use that. And we tried a couple Theater of Blood. That place is awful. I die there so much, and it did not go well. But we will try more of that in the future. I did a lot of theater back in the day, but just kind of need to get back into it. So, working on some more points, working on maybe some boss tasks. I don't know how regular Wilderness Slayer is yet. There was a lot of worlds locked down by groups of people at revs. There are clans that lock them down, but now it's just like regular people doing it because they're crazy. But easy task. I'll just kind of keep popping away at these, and we'll see how many points in total I can get up to at almost 1.2k right now. Oh, they're leaving. Dang it. We just had like a little trio going on. I've never had people come by that were actually competent at the lure and able to duo or trio. Everyone just runs by and messes it up. But yeah, we just did two kills together. It was pretty fun. I had a good time. Had a task of 35 of these. I was able to choose 3 to 35, and I guess I chose 35 for money. I could have chose 3 for points. But yeah, I've enjoyed it. I've gotten 2 elite clues as well, which takes me up to 3 total, so I can do 3 master clues and get some bad clue scroll loot, and I can't wait to do that. So that'll be fun, and yeah, I'll miss those guys. In Nightmare Zone, doing a little bit of defense right now because trying to AFK work on another video that I am doing, and just can't do that in the wilderness while I do Slayer, of course. But what I find hilarious, I mean, my God, I didn't notice this at all when I was wearing this before, but my little mustache hairs just kind of stick out of this helmet. I don't know if it's a graphical glitch, because, like, if I look from this way, nothing's happening, and then nothing. and then boom, you get a nice angle and they're sticking through. So I'm enjoying it out here. I guess Nightmare Zone might be something I do a little bit more. I did it for the first time last video. As far as like actual brain dead AFK things to do in this game, this is one of them. And so I can get some passive XP while I work on other stuff. There are some other skills I do. I'm thinking maybe dark crab fishing for whenever I may need that. But the wilderness is kind of popping. Last time I went and did that, I actually died, and it was pretty depressing. So there's like a 50-man team that logged in on me. Honestly, I was sick to my stomach looking at it. It was awful. So I don't know if I want to go experience that again. But I don't have many more skills in general that can give me like the 2 minutes plus AFK or something like that. So nice to at least still have a little bit of that stuff left at this point of maxing. Wouldn't have been that way on other accounts that I have. All right, so here we go with a smithing level coming in. Gonna go up to 95 with the next adamant plate body. And there we go. Very nice to see a 912k until the next level. This is, I think, the first level of the video. Maybe I've been working on a lot of skills, gotten a lot of XP, but the levels are just hard to come by. But that is okay. That's what comes with the late game grind, and I understand that fully. Don't know what that means. Can I make rune battle axes, which I guess is something. Won't be doing much of that, but there it is. All right, had to look up what that meant. I think he was asking what kind of bars I'm using. Yeah, doing good out here. I actually also have another level, which could take me an undisclosed amount of time to be able to get. I guess me putting an 8 in the middle of the name probably doesn't help the language barrier. But bro, literally trade me. What do you want? Hello? Hello? Okay, bro. I don't know if he wants to know what bars I'm using because he did not trade me. But instead, I'll go ahead and get my level maybe off of some pickpockets here. A lot of XP, but you fail it a ton. Yesterday I got hit like 15 times in a row. So yeah, I'll be back whenever I guess this happens. Maybe right, okay, right now. 95 thieving as well coming in, so top off 2 95s in skills. The smithing one not getting me all too much, but the thieving getting me the ability to no longer fail at the Arty Knight. So I will be doing that. I mentioned in previous episodes that I was going to hop to a world where they lure the knight to a nice little location that no one under 95 in theory should know. My friend told me about this a while ago, and I was pretty excited to go use it, but I asked him what it was called and what the clan chat was, and he had forgotten. So, you know, just absolutely pumped about that. And I guess I'll just go, I mean, the 2.2k worlds and the 2k total worlds typically have people with high thieving levels. Yeah, I guess I'll still have to deal with that. Not exactly the best Arty Knight, but that's okay. And just like that, doing a little bit of Nightmare Zone, kind of AFK'd through it. I was just getting started on a little bit of work, and totally forgot that I was 4k off a level when I came here. So I was gonna say gonna get working on another level. Not quite sure. I mean, I should be used to getting level 95 in skills at this point and should know that they're gonna be 900k away, but they kind of crept up on me. I'm gonna hang out in here a little bit longer. I don't know, the wilderness is pretty tough off. The slayer tasks that we're getting were just rough too. Everything in as far as wilderness slayer was go was pretty bad, so just kind of stayed away from there and have been enjoying this. So I know in the long run I said I wanted to camp bosses and, you know, do PVM related stuff until 99 defense, and I will continue to do some of that, but camping all the way to 99 I don't really think it's necessary, considering I'm probably going to be doing a lot of chambers and theater in the future and stuff like that where I can't necessarily focus defense. So that's okay, and we will continue to get our combat up in here. I don't know if that got me 125 combat. Yep, that actually did get me up to 125 combat, so pretty cool stuff, and only 4 more levels until I can hit max combat. And there we go, finally a 98 to add to the collection. I don't have any of those right now, got a lot of 97s, but finally decided to go ahead and get my hunter up. Was only a little bit of XP away, so came by and did a little inventory. Don't unlock anything with that, but of course I unlocked the ability to be 1.2 mil XP away from 99 hunter. So as far as other 99s that are on the horizon, fishing is something I'm kind of saving, so I don't think that will happen too soon. And herb lore is honestly crazy expensive right now. I got that up to 97 last episode, but I don't know if I'll get that to 99 here in the near future. I might just start kind of pumping up these other levels. Fire making, could definitely see fire making being the next one, as that is pretty easy to level, and stats are just looking as sick as ever. Agility, not so much, but I have done a little bit of it, and honestly, I'm not scared. I'm not. You might be, but I'm not. A lot of time and grind has gone into this level. About to come in with 93 runecrafting here in a second. And yeah, ever since the video of Bloods vs. Souls, I found out that souls are going to be better for them. So I've been trying to do them a little bit more. And that gets me up to 93 runecrafting again. Just absolutely a joy to get runecrafting levels. Don't even want to look at how much XP is next. And I used to think runecrafting was going to be the worst skill to get to 99. But post 77, honestly, has been pretty nice. So I'll take what I can get in that regard. Bank hasn't been going up too much, only up to 803 mil, but Chambers hasn't been very kind to us, per usual. Not exactly sure why this man hates lobsters, but we are here with a farming level as well. Oh my goodness, another 95 yet again. I'm just rounding off to a nice little 5 there, and honestly, it's taken about this long for me to start really enjoying farming. I think that I might even do it post 99. I guess I should start killing a spore a little more if I'm gonna do that, because in theory, I'd be hunting for a pet, but the part of farming that I find to be pretty fun to get down is just the withdrawal from the bank. And honestly, I'm really starting to get it. I haven't messed up a lot of my runs lately. I feel like I'm in a great groove at this point, and it's taken me this long. So yeah, that's pretty tough. I don't know. I was pretty inconsistent with them at the beginning of the account, so I think that's why it took me a while. Now, doing good, and happy to see that total level climb even more. Here we are doing a little bit of construction. Probably not something you expected, but yeah, I mean, this is a skill I saved kind of for late game, because I knew later on in the series I was going to have a bunch of skills that are going to be really slow to train, and that's mostly where we're at, and I wanted something that was going to be nice and quick that I could get some easy levels, and I think I'll start doing that throughout these next couple episodes whenever I'm working on some chambers as well. This allows me to get some easy scaling levels. So yeah, this is the setup. Basically, I have something holding down my one key, and I can remove the door with the one, I can build the door with the one, and as long as the demon respawns whenever I have the door built, then he will spawn right here and I can click on him. It's very, very nice, very convenient. Don't have to move my mouse and don't have to press any keys. It's pretty easy. And also, that is 91 construction, of course. Probably gonna go for another level, I think, and then call it a video at 22-25 total level. No longer in the nice convenient stretch mode, getting 92 construction in fixed, because this is the last level of the episode. So I think that's my second to last stat that I have gotten halfway to 99, so we'll continue to look forward to getting that up and getting me some nice levels in the future. I'll leave this oak dungeon door to live some time in solitude. And as for me, yeah, I mean, 22-25 total level, love to see it, and obviously not gonna have many more chances to round off our total, so very, very nice. And our bank's probably about back down to where we started. Did a little bit of buyables this episode with construction and a little bit of herb lore. Overall though, the bank is looking good, and it's gonna be looking better in future episodes as I've been getting back into doing chambers as Eric, and I've even raged a couple times at Theater of Blood already. So we'll do more of that next episode. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this one. If you guys did, make sure to leave a like. Anything you want to tell me, let me know in a comment down below. And on top of that, if you want to see more videos like this as soon as they go live, make sure to subscribe. Likely we'll be streaming later on Twitch. Usually I go live right after the video, but it will be a bit later tonight. So go down there, leave a follow if you need to. And with that said, hopefully you guys have a wonderful day, and deuces.